exposure to the blood of a symptomatic colleague, I found myself making my way up the stairs to this room. And I am not alone. Everyone who's infected, we've all come up here wanting to get outside. I know full well I mustn't leave, given the possibility I'm infected. Yet, I can't contain this urge I feel inside me, like the alcoholic who tries to make any excuse for one more drink. Every step I took up those stairs filled me with this sense of bliss. I still have all my wits about me. It took no time at all to rewire the electronic lock and open the emergency exit. Then, just as I was about to set foot outside, I finally realized what was going on. This desire for freedom is not my own, but that of the vocal cord parasites inside me. They want the ravens to feed on us, pecking us to death, attracted by these sweet secretions. They have mutated to facilitate this. The sweet smell is powerful enough to attract even a species with such a weak nose. So, before the parasites take complete control, I must. Most of the staff in here are already infected. At least, everyone I've looked at is. Infection with this parasite causes a high fever in the pharynx. I have modified a pair of night vision goggles to react only to this temperature range. With these goggles, you can identify who is infected. Other infected will, like me, feel compelled to make it outside. If the ravens get their meal, they'll head for land next. That cannot be allowed to happen.
The idea of the vocal cord parasites was that they'd only copulate once exposed to a specific language over time. But the parasites infecting our men in the laboratory laid their eggs straight away. The larvae were eating their lung tissue almost immediately. What kind of mutation was it?
Those who were infected and cured still carried the vocal cord parasites in their throats. They were still there. But the males had been rendered female by the Volbachia, and copulation could not occur. So we thought. But it is the Volbachia that mutated.
Not the parasites?
You remember I told you the Volbachia attempts to maximize its number of female infected hosts?
Yes, hence the male to female transformation.
Precisely. But other Wolbachia strains use different methods. Cytoplasmic incompatibility, killing the males, and parthenogenesis.
Parthenogenesis? Aphids? Aphids use that to reproduce via females.
That's the target.
Very good. The females lay their eggs without a male present, creating clones of themselves in explosive numbers. Parthenogenesis was originally a means for an organism to take maximum advantage of abundant resources by increasing its numbers. Certain strains of Wolbachia force this to occur, to create more and more infected females.
And that's why our men develop symptoms in the blink of an eye.
Wolbachia causing parthenogenesis is common in parasitic wasps. Of course, the Wolbachia I introduced to you men didn't have a characteristic. But I believe the mutation, whatever it was, caused it to force parthenogenesis in its host, the vocal cord parasites. The Wolbachia we used to prevent egg laying became the agent of limitless reproduction.
There's something else. The symptomatic infected in the laboratory all wanted to get outside, even knowing there was napalm waiting for them out there. You said the parasites made them act that way, but parasites controlling humans. Is it possible?
Parasites altering the host's behavior.
Subject on board. Leave the rest to us.
In the world of nature, long ago, the vocal cord parasites had this ability. But even I never foresaw they might control humans. Until I heard the things your man said.
You mean the researcher on the top floor? The bit about, I'm not a snail.
Not good. Don't let your buddy die, Snake. I'm pulling them out of there.
Leucochloridium that uses snails as intermediary hosts. As you know, snails prefer dark, gloomy environments. But once parasitized by Leucochloridium, they desire to be in the light. And that is not all. The parasites thrust themselves into the snail's antennae, making them swell to abnormal size. The snail, meanwhile, frantically wriggles his antennae.
Snake! Talk to me! Snake!
There's something else. The symptomatic infected in the laboratory all wanted
that's the target.
Even knowing there was napalm waiting for them out there. You said the parasites made them act that way. But parasites controlling humans. Is it possible?
Parasites altering the host's behavior is a common occurrence in the world of nature. Long ago, the vocal cord parasites had this ability. But even I never foresaw they might control humans. Until I heard the things your man said.
You mean the researcher on the top floor? The bit about, I'm not a snail.
Yes. Among parasitic groups, there is a genus called Leucochloridium that uses snails as intermediary hosts. As you know, snails prefer dark, gloomy environments. But once parasitized by Leucochloridium,
you gotta extract him.
To be in the light. And that is the parasitic worms thrust themselves into the snail's antennae, making them swell to abnormal size. The snail, meanwhile, frantically wiggles his antennae.
He's coming too. Roger that.
The swollen, wriggling antennae soon resemble caterpillars.
I don't get it.
It is so they can be eaten by birds. Leucochloridium needs a bird as its definitive host to breed. They require their snail host to be snapped up by a predator. So they make the humble snail appear to be a delicious caterpillar and lead it to somewhere in open sight.
So you mean the staff trying to get outside
was so the birds could pick at them. The parasites altered their mental state, making them crave higher places and to be outdoors.
Snake, are you okay? Snake!
There's something else. The symptomatic
environments, but once iridium, they desire, and that is antennae, making the snail his antennae, the sword.
I don't get it.
It is so they can be eaten by birds. Leucochloridium needs a bird as a
that's the target
to breed. They require their snail host to be snapped up by a predator. So they make the humble snail appear to be a delicious caterpillar and lead it to somewhere in open sight.
So you mean the staff trying to get outside?
Was so the birds could pick at them. The parasites altered their mental state, making them crave higher places and to be outdoors. I can only surmise that both the Wolbachia and the parasites mutated before the ancestors of the vocal cord parasites infected humans. Their hosts were birds. What we saw in the laboratory was a throwback to that time. The parasites attempting to make birds their intermediary hosts.
Sounds insane.
A praying mantis that is host to a parasitic hairworm.
You gotta extract him?
Water and drown itself. Just so the hairworm can lay its eggs in water. Rats infected with Toxoplasma gondii lose their instinctive caution and run right up to cats. Just some of the many ways parasites control the host.
But we're humans. Surely our minds are too complex for that.
I thought just the same. Free will is what makes us human, so it never occurred to me that the parasites could be controlling the symptomatic. But the mood, the will of a person can be easily affected by the balance of their cerebral substances. Take the toxoplasma I mentioned. It does infect humans, and it is thought the infected develop a more reckless attitude.
But to think that mutations occurred in both the Wolbachia and its parasite hosts.
Your observation is most apt. Both mutations occurring at once indicates the presence of a powerful mutation.
I see. Keep working on narrowing down the
He's coming through. Roger that.
Get him!
Something else. It's even knowing.
Toxoplasma gondii lose their instinctive caution and run right up to cats. Just some of the many ways parasites control the host.
But we're humans. Surely our minds are too complex for that.
I thought just the same. Free will is what makes us human. So it never occurred to me that the parasites could be controlling the symptomatic. But the mood, the will of a person can be easily affected by the balance of their cerebral substances. Take the toxoplasma I mentioned. It does infect humans, and it is thought the infected develop a more reckless attitude.
But to think that mutations occurred in both the Wolbachia and its parasite host...
You gotta extract him.
Observation is most apt. Both mutations occurring at once indicates the presence of a powerful mutagen.
I see. Keep working on narrowing down what it was. Incident at the quarantine facility. Assuming the vocal cord parasite underwent a mutation. The only plausible explanations are exposure to some high concentration mutagen or radiation. As you know, some of the staff at the quarantine facility were infected with the parasites. The Wolbachia prevented them from copulating, but the parasites themselves can't be removed from their host's vocal cords. Once you're infected with Skullface's parting gift, you're stuck with it. The researchers regularly used X-ray equipment to monitor the parasites in their throats. No problem there, they kept a close eye on the radiation doses. But that equipment didn't just give off X-rays. It was also emitting beta rays. Even though that's unnecessary for the scans, see, beta rays have far worse effects on DNA than X-rays. Meaning the only logical conclusion is that someone added in a beta ray emitter to trigger a mutation. Those beta rays leaked out from inside the equipment. Because the emitter was retrofitted, the shielding was inadequate. And the person who ordered and inspected the equipment was you, Doctor. That makes you the only person with the opportunity to install that emitter.
So now you're saying I sabotaged medical equipment for some wild plan to make the vocal cord parasite kill everyone?
Or maybe you thought it'd reveal a way to treat the parasite without using the Wolbachia. With that much to barter, I suppose some people would welcome even a pathetic cur like you.
Just stop it!
You'd have no shortage of buyers. But most would be happy with just the parasite. You wouldn't need to offer anything else. However, if that buyer already knew about the parasite, they'd also... So know that by itself, it's no longer the ultimate bargaining chip it once was. To sell to that buyer, you need to throw in a bonus. A way to one-up it. There's only one buyer who'd be after that.
Emmerich, we record all communications on Mother Base. That includes radio transmissions to and from homemade devices. You've been in frequent contact with people in America. a private biotech company, a client of which is DARPA. And they are connected to Cypher. You made a deal with Cypher. You offered them a new parasite in exchange for your safety. This is the only place in the world where the vocal cord parasite still exists. And you used it as a testing ground, tried to resurrect their bioweapon. But your plan to obtain the parasite has failed. Your bullshit ends now. And don't think you're leaving here alive.
He's coming too. Roger that. By the enemy. He was on the staff at Mother Base 9 years back. Get our man out of there, boss. To say he's a critical VIP would be a massive understatement.
Attack!
Subject on board. Leave the rest to us.
Not here.
about a minute? It's about the quarantine facility. We've more or less figured out what caused the mutation in the vocal cord parasites. It was the radiation from that scanner. And the one who installed it was Emmerich. I've added a tape recording of the interrogation. You should listen to it.
Wait, what are you talking about? Just what do you plan to do?
Present the charges against you and render an appropriate punishment.
You're gonna put me on trial?
Call it what you like.
What's the meaning of this?
Out of here, all of you. Back to your posts.
No, hang on. Huey has killed their comrades and interfered with their lives. They've had all they can take.
Kill that son of a bitch!
Stop! This is insane! You have no evidence whatsoever! You say you're an army free from governments. You talk big about being a nation unto yourselves. But from the outside, you're just thugs, rebels, a militia. You terrorists, an unhinged threat to society. You're nothing but a bunch of psychopaths!
You're? So you're not with us?
No! I didn't...
I thought we were on the same side. That's too bad.
I didn't mean...
Meg, you will have justice. But our organization, the boss's organization, is built on order and reason. There will be no lynch mob. So stand down for today.
We will gather all the evidence of this man's crimes. And then he will be tried.
Dismiss!
What do you think you're doing? Go ahead and execute me. It'll be murder in the eyes of the world. You've lost your minds! Don't you get it? You're seeing phantoms! Just look at that dog! No! You named him D-Dog, but it's obvious anyone could see that's a wolf! Because you're all a bunch of wild dogs! You wanted to believe he was too! To feel some connection, to fight your loneliness. You wanted something to cling to prove you deserve to be alive. You wanted to forget the death, your sins, so you'd cling on to dogs, or wolves, or even Big Boss. The boss is the same, isn't he? Every one of you is alone. That's why you suspect your own. I know. Because I'd do the same. I'm one of you too. Alone.
He's coming too. Roger that.
Open your eyes! What you're doing is murder! Plain and simple. All you ever create is war! War and violence can never lead to peace!
Thank you.
about the quarantine facility. We've more or less figured out what caused the mutation in the vocal cord parasites. It was the radiation from that scanner. And the one who installed it was Emmerich. I've added a tape recording of the interrogation. You should listen to it.
Thank you. Hey, quit kidding around. Snake? Snake!
Fuck off. Oh. attack.
Here.
you okay? Snake!
Target. coming too. Roger that. Roger. target. Subject on board. Leave the rest to us.
To me! Snake! What?
subject on board. Leave the rest to us.
Extract him. Roger.
Welcome back, boss.
Thank you, boss.
Roger.
This is Pequot. Arriving shortly at LZ. This is Pequot. On station at LZ. Thank you.
Previous angle is fin. The oil runs to the pipeline from that facility. Taking it out should end the leak. The client this time is an environmental NGO. Destroy the facility. Stop that leak. This may seem like straight-up philanthropy, but there's another reason we agreed to it. The Mafinda oil field was outdated, abandoned. Then the rebel group UNITA moved in, taking it upon themselves to kickstart operations. UNITA's been rapidly modernizing its arsenal. Rumor has it someone's been selling them U.S. military hardware. Intel's analysis suggests the broker's a front company, Cyphers. Keeping tabs on UNITA could tell us who's pulling its strings. Resource exploitation, tribal clashes. You've arrived at Masa Village. It's been turned into a supply hub for UNITA, meaning it'll be stocked with weapons and resources. Should be a thing or two that'll come in handy. Don't be shy. They deserve to be in better hands.
Get him!
Over.
Where are your friends?
Roger that. You gotta extract him. Where are your friends?
Spit it out. Where are your friends?
Okay. Subject on board. Leave the rest to us.
ready? What the donut wants for Kreski?
Mission failed, boss.
Boss, destroy the oil facility and stop the flow of oil. You've got a straight path to the objective. You should find it no problem. Thank you. too. Roger that. Saner, South African Natural Resources. Saner drills oil wells wherever they can throughout that region. When the oil dries up, they abandon the facility. Then it's only a matter of time before the aging equipment starts leaking crude. That means UNITA's takeover is the perfect cover for Saner. Now they can blame the spill on a bunch of oil thieves. However you look at it, Saner's far from squeaky clean. Separator tank. The details are on your iDroid.
Mission failed, boss.
Boss, destroy the oil facility and stop the flow of oil. To prevent the machinery being turned back on again, you need to turn off the oil transfer pump and destroy the oily water separator tank. Check the details on your iDroid.
Mission's a failure.
Boss, destroy the oil facility and stop the flow of oil. To prevent the machinery being turned back on again, you need to turn off the oil transfer pump and destroy the oily water separator tank. Check the details on your iDroid.
Mission failed, boss!
Boss, destroy the oil facility and stop the flow of oil. To prevent the machinery being turned back on again, you need to turn off the oil transfer pump and destroy the oily water separator tank. Check the details on your iDroid.
Separator tank. One of the targets. Take it out.
Yeah. опасный. Но там все зверушки. Эйт!
Subject on board. Leave the rest to us. Transfer pump control room. The emergency stop button is probably inside it.
Ask his father to speak to him. 8.
Walker Gears, what are they doing there? Thank you. too. Roger that.
Attack!
Extract him.
pass the time, go ahead and smoke that cigar of yours.
Mission's a failure.